Undoubtedly, one of the best parts of Adobe Character Animator is the automatic lip sync. As I'm talking and saying different sounds, ah, e, ooh, all that stuff, my character is going to be doing the same based on the up to 14 different mouth shapes that I can put in my original Photoshop or Illustrator file. But every once in a while, things are not going to work 100%, and you find yourself spending some extra time fine-tuning all those little visemes, those visual mouth shapes, to make sure they look as good as possible. It would be nice if there was an easier way to make the lip sync as accurate as possible, particularly if you had a script of what your character is going to say. And luckily, now that can help you a lot because in the latest version of Adobe Character Animator, we have now added transcript-based lip sync. So you have several methods of recording lip sync in Character Animator, right? You can just talk like I'm doing right now, and as long as the lip sync behavior is armed red over here and the microphone icon is blue, then as soon as I press this red record button, it's going to record not only the audio, but all the different mouth shapes automatically in real time as I do it. Now, if you add an external audio file, if you have a friend that's got a great voice or someone else that you've added, you can just take this audio file. File import is going to bring it into your project panel, and then I can just drag it over into my scene. It's going to show up down here, and then I can go to timeline, compute lip sync take from scene audio. That is going to analyze the audio file and give me all my mouth shapes. So if I zoom in here, I can see all the different mouth shapes that were computed based off of that audio file. And to be honest, the results are really good. I can play this back and things are looking pretty nice. They do seem to line up pretty much one-to-one with the things that I'm saying up above. And you can see that with the audio file and how it matches up. But notice sometimes there's some extra stuff here. It's picking up like this S sound that definitely wasn't there. Now I can always right click and change this or made silence or whatever I want, but it's a pretty manual process, right? And wouldn't you rather be spending your time doing other stuff instead of making sure that the A sound stops at frame 23 and the O sound starts at the next one? It's a very tedious process to do all this lip sync fixing. So now we have another way to do things, and in my mind, this is the most accurate way to get the best lip sync possible, and that is transcript-based lip sync. So here I've imported my audio file birdhouse.aiff. This is the initial verse to Birdhouse in Your Soul by They Might Be Giants, great song. And I'm going to go ahead and select it here in the project panel. And I'll notice over here on the right-hand side in my properties that I've got this new window called Transcript. I can import an SRT file. I'll do that in a little bit. But right now I'm just gonna copy and paste some lyrics I found on the web of this initial verse. And now this is attached to this audio file. And if I look in the project panel now, my audio icon has changed to have a little T next to it, making me realize, okay, there's some transcript data that is associated with this audio file. So now let's do the same process I did before, where I drag this into my scene and it's going to show up here just like it did before. I'm gonna zoom out a little bit. But now what I can do is select the character that I want the lip sync to be applied to. I'm gonna hold down shift and also select the audio that I want to have the lip sync happen to. And then I'm gonna go to timeline, and there's a new feature right here, compute lip sync take from audio and transcript. So let's go ahead and try that. Now, a quick glance, you might not notice a major difference between the old method of doing things and the new method of doing things. But let's take a closer look at how these two stack up against each other. So here on the top, which corresponds to this character on the left-hand side, I've got the old method of doing things, basically just dragging the character in and saying timeline compute lip sync, compute take from scene audio. And then on the bottom here with the guy on the right, I have the new method, including the transcript. So let's just look at this one line where I say, make a little birdhouse in your soul. And the immediate thing that I notice is I'm getting more mouth shapes down here than I am at the top. It's able to take the text and understand exactly where those breaks are, as opposed to just trying to analyze it without that extra information. And so I'm just getting a slightly more accurate reading. Now, it's not a major difference, right? I think this is 14 mouth shapes up here versus a 19 down here, so you're missing 5 mouth shapes from the top. So for a lot of people, maybe this is okay up here. But if you're doing a more professional final piece and you do want that lip sync to look as good as possible and you've got the script, you might as well do it this way because you're just gonna get better results overall. So let's take the beginning of this, make a little birdhouse in your soul. With the new one, I've got M, it immediately knows that make, the M mouth, is the correct shape. Whereas in this one, it was thinking it was a D for some reason. It was picking up on that. And even on the ending here, I see soul. This one only ends the old method with the O, whereas this one does get that L for soul and adds that extra part. That's another thing I see a lot with transcript-based lip-syncing is it adds these little in-between or extra things that really help sell the mouth moving. So you're always going to get those big vowel shapes, right? Ah, e, oo. Those will probably be pretty consistent, but a transitional mouse like an F or an L or something like that, you don't see them as much. Those are a little harder to detect with the normal method. But when you have an actual F or L in the text, then we can identify that a lot easier, and you're going to get a lot more accurate results with that. Blue canary in the outlet by the light switch, who watches over you. Make a little birdhouse in your soul. Not to put too fine a point on it, say I'm the only bee in your bonnet. Make a little birdhouse in your soul. Now I'm going to jump into Premiere Pro for a second for two reasons. Number one, there may be instances where you actually don't have a script. You were just doing improv or just talking off the cuff and you don't have that script and you want to get a transcript to be able to use in Character Animator. Secondly, you may have a script, but you want the most accurate results and you want some timing information to be able to create an SRT file. That is basically a script with the timing to say when captions are going to show up. And we can use that information to make the results even more accurate in Character Animator. So here, I just imported my audio file. I didn't even bring in any video to Premiere Pro. I added this to a new sequence down here. And so now I've got my, 1 minute, 36 second sequence here. And I've used a slightly longer version of Birdhouse in Your Soul. And I'm going to go ahead and in the text panel up here, which if you don't see it, I'm in the captions workspace, or you can just go to Window, Text to find this. I'm just going to go ahead and say create transcription. And all those details look good. Let's go to transcribe. And this is going to look through this audio file and give me the best transcription it possibly can. So there we go. Now I have a transcription of everything that was said in this particular verse, and it's all showing up over here. Now I can go through it, and if I see things that are incorrect, if it has a little orange line under it, it means it's not 100% confident that this is the correct word. So I can always double click into here and type whatever I want if I needed to change it. But honestly, as I'm going through this, it is pretty accurate most of the way. So I might have a few changes, but overall, I'm really liking how this is looking. But this is a really broad time range, right? It's saying from, under 1 second to 16 seconds, I say all these different things. That's fine, but I'd like a little bit more information and split this up a little bit more. And that's why I want to also do the step of create captions. This is going to break this up even more into further chunks and just make it work a lot better. So let's go ahead and do that. Click on create captions. Click create. And now I have this beautiful little subtitle track here. And you can see as I scroll through this, it's going through all my different lines. And I also see my subtitles over here. And again, I can still make changes here if I want to change what's being said. But now I have a really accurate timing for everything that I'm saying. So instead of that 16 second chunk, now I've got 3 seconds here, 4 seconds here, 4 seconds here. It's much smaller chunks, and that's going to be a lot easier for a character animator to make sure everything lines up correctly. So I want to get this information out of Premiere and into Character Animator, and the way I would do that is click this little three-line ellipses button up here, and let's export this to an SRT file. And I can call that whatever I want, so let's just put that on my desktop, and we will say save. All right, so back in Character Animator, I've now imported this Birdhouse long sound file. And instead of typing in or pasting the text down here, I'm gonna go ahead and go to Import. I'm going to find that long SRT file. I'm gonna click Import there. And now look what happens. Not only do I have the text showing up, but I have the timecode information as well. And this should help the results be even more accurate. So let's go ahead and try it, right? So I'm gonna take this, and just like before, I'm gonna drag this into my scene. Now it shows up here. I've got everything showing up. I'm gonna select my character, shift select the audio that I want to show up, and then go to timeline, compute lip sync take from audio and transcript. And once that's done, now I have all of my mouse shapes down here as accurate as I can possibly make them. Now, there will probably still be a few little issues here and there that you might want to tweak, either for it's the wrong mouse shape or for stylistic reasons, if you want to hold a note or something like that, hold this particular mouse shape. But I've used this a lot. I used this in the last consoles video I did for the Switch character, and this worked awesome. Significantly better results and less time spent on fixing lip sync than the old version. So I highly recommend this, at least giving it a try. I think it's going to lead to some really great results. All right, so let's talk about troubleshooting. Let's say you try transcript-based lip sync and something isn't working right. You get some sort of error message or it's not quite lining up correctly. What would you do to fix this? So I'm going to walk through some of the most common scenarios and talk about how I would go about fixing each of them. The first thing is, if you are not using an SRT file, so if you don't have all that time data for where everything lies, then there is a time limit on how much you can do at any given time, and that is 160 seconds. So I'll show you what I mean. So here I've got an audio file that actually goes for 3 minutes and 30 seconds. And if I go to my audio here, I can see that I've just copied and pasted some text lyrics that I found online. But if I try to do this, if I try to go through the compute lip sync take from audio and transcript, what's gonna happen is I'm going to get this little error message right here. And it says, audio is too long to compute lip sync using a transcript, more than 160 seconds. So basically this is just added this little marker here that I can move around or delete, but it's telling me that my audio is too long. So I've got two options here. Number one, I could do probably the best thing, which is to import an SRT file instead of this text. So I'll go ahead and click on import, find that SRT file that's got all the information, time information on it, go ahead and import it. And now I'm good to go and I can do it for as long as I want. Okay, that's option one. Option two would be you have to break it up into chunks and do up to 160 seconds at a time. This is a little more tedious and manual, but it is possible. The way you would do that is find a good split point like here that's less than 160 seconds. I'm gonna go to my audio file and go to edit split, and that's gonna split it into two separate sections. Now I'm going to take a look at this and say, okay, what's the word, the last word right here at, you know, a 1 minute, 42 seconds. And then I would go here into my transcript and say, okay, the last word right here is rest. I'm going to delete everything else that's after it. And then I'm going to, so now I just have that first 1 minute, 42 seconds. Now I'm going to go through that process again, timeline, compute, lip sync from audio and transcript. And then once that's done, I've got to do the same thing for this and move on to the next one. And I would have to go back into the transcript and undo the deletion or re-import the text or just copy and paste the text that is only this part of the audio from 142 to 330 and then do the computation process over again. You see what I'm saying? Like the SRT file makes a lot more sense, right? So when in doubt, use that. Next up, languages. For V1, transcript-based lip sync is primarily English-based. The results are going to work the best in the English language. But anything that uses the Latin alphabet, so if you're seeing A, E, T, V, all of those types of symbols, English, you know, German, French, Spanish, all of that, then you should get still pretty good results. It's if you're using non-Latin characters in other languages, Russian, Chinese, things like that, that you may run into, it's not going to work at all, actually. So this is a current limitation. And again, we do hope to make this better in the future. I have heard that accented symbols can sometimes lead to issues as well. So you may want to try to leave those out if you are running into any error messages or inaccurate results. Again, hope to fix this in the future. Number three, if you have a choice between just copying and pasting text and using SRT data, use the SRT. Those extra time code things are going to help tremendously in the accuracy of your whole piece. And so if you have the ability to go into Printbird Pro or you've got an SRT from anywhere else, or you're adding the time coding manually, whatever, that's your best method into getting the most accurate results and the least amount of errors. Next, sometimes Character Animator isn't going to be able to figure everything out. And unfortunately, it's going to not be able to line up the text with what you're saying. It's just the analysis doesn't work. And when we do that, we try to be as smart as we can about it. So what I'm going to do here is add an extra word, birdhouse, in here. It's not part of it. I don't say this word. Let's see what happens if I were to do the normal process here. So let's select these, timeline, compute, lip sync from audio and transcript, and let's see what happens. Okay, so you can see what happened here is it started analyzing and it did pretty good until it got to that birdhouse, that extra word that I added in, right here around 3 seconds. And then it gave about a 5 second gap before it started analyzing again and doing more where it could. So what you get is a little marker here in the timeline, and it says compute lip sync failed. Check that the transcript matches the audio. So now I can see the exact spot in the timeline around 3 seconds right here where the problem persists. And I can say, oh, you know what? I did have that extra word in there, or I need to, you know, change something here. And I can always, you know, if I wanted to redo this whole thing, just delete these lip sync tracks, make the change in my transcript. Okay, let's take birdhouse out or fix whatever the problem was, and then rerun the whole process and you should be good to go. So that little marker is gonna show you where the problem areas are. And hopefully that gives you pinpointed data as to what you need to fix. Finally, one thing I've noticed is that numbers sometimes throw things off. So you have a number like a year, 1998 or whatever, or some sort of number that you have. You may want to write out the number. So instead of the number 4, I would write F-O-U-R instead. And that can tend to lead to less errors and more accurate results. So that is transcript-based lip sync. We know this is a V1. We know there's so much more we want to do with this and continue to improve it in the future. Lip sync has always been a top priority for us. And you should notice that in every release, lip sync gets a little bit better and better. And now with the transcript-based lip sync, you have just one more tool in your arsenal to make that lip sync look as good as you possibly can. But if things aren't working for you, we would love to hear about it. If you know you're running into trouble, or you try it, or you see errors that you have no idea how to fix, let us know in the forums. The best place to get help is the official Character Animator forums. And if you are using transcript-based lip sync in any of your work, we'd love to see how it's working. So please use hashtag Character Animator when sharing on social media so we can see how it's looking out there in the wild. All right, that is it for today. Thank you so much for watching, and have fun.